Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over how to split a full name into two separate columns.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So here we have a spreadsheet where the first name and the last name is all in one column. And we would like to split this into the first name in column B and the last name in column C. If you would like to follow along, you can download a sample file from the link in our description, or you can look at the card right here on YouTube. And if I look over here, I can tell that that natural break is where there is a space here. So for this, we are going to use four functions: the left function, the find function, the right function, and the length function. But to get the first name, we are going to start with the left function. So if I click in B2 and type equals, I am going to want to take the left part of the string until I get to the space. But unfortunately, the space is somewhere different for each one of these because the first name is not the same amount of letters. So let's start with typing in left and a left parenthesis. So the first argument I'm being prompted for is, what text do I want to take the left out of? So I want to take it out of A2. So I'm just going to click on A2 and then type comma. And then my next argument is, how many characters do I want to count to on the left of this string? And for that, I'm going to use the find function. So if I type find with a left parenthesis, the first argument I'm being prompted for is find text. What text do I want to find here? Well, I want to find the space. So I'm going to put a double quote, a space, and then another double quote. And then I'm going to type a comma. And then what text am I looking for that space in? Well, it's going to be right here. And I'm going to close my parenthesis for the find function. And then I'm going to close my parenthesis for the left function. And I'm going to hit enter. However, there is a space at the end of this. You can't see it right now, but I know there's a space at the end of this. And if I go into column D and I type equals right, a left parenthesis, and I pick this text, and I get my rightmost character by doing comma one, close my parentheses and hit enter, you can see it's not an L. It actually is a space. So there's a couple things you can do to get rid of that. So let's leave this formula here for a minute so you can see what I mean. So if I go back to here, I can either type in between my two parentheses where it still says number of characters, where it's highlighted, and I can type minus one, and I can hit enter. And now look over here, you can see L is now my rightmost character, not a space. So if I click back over here and I don't want to do the minus one, I can just take that out and I can put a function in the beginning of here called trim with a left parenthesis and then go to the end of this whole formula and put a right parenthesis and hit enter. And the trim function will take out any spaces in the beginning or end of your word. And you can still see the L here is my rightmost character.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So let's look at last name. Now the last name is on the right-hand side of this string after the space. And that gets a little more tricky, but that's how you would build this function. But to get that out, we're going to start with the right function. So I'm going to type equals right with a left parenthesis, and I want the right of what text string? Well, I'm going to click back on A2, and I'm going to type a comma. And then how many characters do I want? Well, I don't know because the last names are always a different number of characters. So what I'm going to do, and think through this with me, if I count out how many characters there are in this entire string, there's 7, 8 with the space, and 5 more. So there's 13 total. And then if I subtract 13 minus the 8th character right here where the space is, then I will get 13 for the whole string minus 8, which will give me my 5. So check that out down here. There's 7, 8 with the space, and then there's 6 more. So that's going to be 14 minus 8, which is where the space is. So 14 minus 8 will give you the 6 for the last name here. So the number of characters, first we're going to take the whole length of the string with a left parenthesis, and I'm going to click on the text here because this is the whole length of the string that I want. Close my parenthesis, and now I'm going to do minus the find statement again. Find left parenthesis, and I'm going to type double quote, space, double quote, and a comma within this string right here. I'm going to close parentheses for find, and then I'm going to close parentheses for the right statement and hit enter. And you can now see that Scott has appeared here, and there is no leading space. It's a little easier here to see that there's no leading space. So if I highlight B and C, and if you look down here at the bottom right-hand corner of C2, you'll see how there's kind of a square there. If I double-click this square, I can flash fill all the formulas for the first and last name. And if I wanted to go over here for my right, so I can make sure I don't have an ending space in column B, I can also go down to the rightmost part of this cell and double-click, and I can see that I'm getting all the first name last letters here as well. So a lot of times when you're using the left function, sometimes you want to either use trim or a minus one when you're doing the number of characters, if you're using a find statement. Because usually the find statement will go all the way up to the character that you're actually looking for, and you want it to be one less. And then for the write function, a lot of times you're going to use the entire length of the string minus where you find the character that you are looking for. So hopefully that gives you a good introduction for using some string functions in order to split names or split other strings that you may have where you have an identifying character inside of that string. You can see another example for splitting strings on our blog at the link below in the description. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.